الحمد لله غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو وإليه المصير. الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل وكبره تكبيرا. My dear brothers and sisters, my dearest children, I began by praising Allah Azza wa Jal, the one whom we praise and the one whom we ask for help and forgiveness. And I seek refuge by Allah from the evil of myself and the evil of my deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, none would be able to misguide. And whomsoever Allah allowed to be misguided, none would be able to guide. And I praised Allah Azza wa Jal, the forgiver of the sins, the acceptor of the repentance, the severe in punishment. Nothing is comparable to Him, to Him we shall all return. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين تركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. And I bear witness that there is no God worthy the worshipping except Allah, the One, the Sufficient Master. He begots not, nor He was begotten, and there is none co-equal nor comparable unto Him. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last and the final messenger of Allah. He sent him to us with the message of Islam. And he struggled so hard and exercised jihad in the true meanings of jihad to ensure that what we have today in our hands is the last and the final message from Allah. عباد الله أوصيكم ونفس المقصرة بتقوى الله وأحذركم ونفسي من عصيانه ومخالفة أمره لزوما لقوله الحق تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وكذلك في قول الحق تبارك وتعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا اتقوا الله فإن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. I began by encouraging you and myself first of all to fulfill the commands of Allah, and I warned you and myself first of all from disobeying Him, according to Him telling us in the Quran, O you who believe, fear Allah the way He should be feared and by not accepting the state of Islam. And for Him also telling us in the Quran, O mankind, fear your Lord, the one who created you from one soul and created its mate from it and created from them so many men and women. And fear your Lord, by whose name you demand your mutual rights from one another. And fear your Lord, by observing the right of your blood tie relatives, your rahim. Fear your Lord, as those who do not fear, as the shaking of the hour is so horrible. When you see the pregnant dropping her load, and you see people walking in the state of a drunken, and they're not drunken, it's the torment of Allah Azza wa Jal that is so severe in that day. My dear brothers and sisters, my dearest children, we are in Al-Jum'a Al-Yateema, as it is traditionally called, in which refers to the orphan Jum'a, the last Jum'a of the month of Ramadan. And as we have stood in the beginning of the month of Ramadan and said, we are starting the month of Ramadan, and before we know it, we will be saying goodbye to the month of Ramadan. And Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, we cannot thank Allah enough for the fact that He have given us this precious gift that's called life. And for the fact that He have chosen us among billions on earth to say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. And we can't thank Him enough that He have made us from those who surrender to Him and submit to His will 5 times a day during our daily salawat. And we can't thank him enough that he enabled us to witness another Ramadan in our life. And we can't thank him enough that it has been possible for us to fast for him and come to the masajid and be able to offer the salawat, hoping that we will be from those whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that man sama Ramadan and imanan wa ihtisaban ghufir lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. Whoever fasts the month of Ramadan for the sake of the mighty, then his sins will be forgiven. And hoping that we will be from those man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban faqad ghufir lahu min dhanbi. And whoever stands between the hands of Allah praying to him throughout the salawat of Taraweeh and other nafil, then his sins are forgiving. And we pray to him that he will enable us to be able to gain Laylatul Qadr, which is a Laylatun khayrun min alf shahr. It's not equal to 1,000 months, but it is more in value than 1,000 months. If you were to ask us, how has been Ramadan to you? What's the most challenging? Some of us might be saying, and those who work in labor jobs, it's been the physical work that, and I cannot wait until the end of the day to be able to get some nourishment, to help me be able to sustain myself and keep going in my daily life activities. Others would say, food is nothing. All I need is water. I can't wait until I break my fast to quench my thirst with a big bottle of water, cold one. Others would say, I don't care about food or water. What's been difficult for me is the lack of sleep. As we have been able, alhamdulillah, from the gracious bounties of Allah Azza wa Jal, been able to stand between his hands until midnight. And then by the time we go home, we will be probably relaxing or resting a little bit. تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. We will be hoping that we will be included in this ayah in which the Prophet, with which Allah the Mighty said that تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ. Their sides are distant away from their mattresses and their comfortable bed out of the love of Allah Azza wa Jal. We are, alhamdulillah, privileged. But the case is not the same, unfortunately, for the Muslims in Gaza. For the Muslims of Gaza, since the beginning of the month of Ramadan, they have not been able to find food to be able to nourish themselves. They have not been able to find a clean or maybe any source of water to be able to quench their thirst upon the time they break their fast. And unfortunately, and this is something I cannot myself imagine, have not been able to put their head on the pillow to be able to get some comfortable sleep. The air rides since the beginning of this assault on Gaza since July 5 has not made it possible for the people of Gaza to be able to rest. There is an average of an airstrike every 4 minutes so far. There has been homes demolished on the heads of their own people. They go to sleep hoping to be able to get some rest, and they don't know whether they will be able to wake up or not. Or whether when they wake up, would they be able to see their own family members or not. Maybe when they wake up after their house has been shelled and they are under the rebels, they would look around to find their own children, فَلَذَاتُ أَكْبَادِهِمْ, torn apart, torn to pieces. Or they would probably see their own spouse lying next to them, bleeding, have left this dunya to the akhirah. This is what's happening, unfortunately, to the Muslims of Gaza, and to a similar extent to the Muslims of Syria, and to a similar extent to the Muslims of Iraq, and name it. We are, alhamdulillah, privileged to be able to come to the Salah. We have made it to the night of 27 to the Masjid to be able to stand between the hands of Allah. Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa is crying. Because the Israelis have prevented Muslims from making it to the Masjid al-Aqsa in the blessed nights of the month of Ramadan. They have prevented all young people from entering Masjid al-Aqsa. A checkpoint upon checkpoint. And they have made it difficult and impossible for people to make it to Masjid al-Aqsa to worship Allah in most beautiful days and nights of the whole year. Many of us have been listening to the media. And it has been a sign today throughout Canada that imams needs to speak up about what's happening to our Muslim fellows in Gaza and defeat the propaganda that has been labeling Muslims are being terrorists. This is a propaganda that has no merits, that has no value, that is a big lie, and it's a big shame on the international community, whether it is the United Nations or whether it is the most powerful nation on earth, to see and watch what is happening in Gaza, and not only to keep a shut mouth, but to continue to support the war machine of the most powerful army on earth, to continue to bombard the civilians. Since the beginning of this assault, there has been over 833 up to before coming to the masjid. 833 people have fallen as shuhada, inshallah, to their Lord. Mainly civilians, mainly children, mainly women, mainly elders. And one cannot help it to wonder how many Israeli civilians have been killed throughout this time. And you can answer this by yourself and say that there has been no civilians from Israel falling down and being killed. Is it not the homemade rockets from Palestinians which are trying to attack people's attention have reached almost every single city of the Israelis? Yes, it did. But these rockets are launched by people who have ethics. I launched by people who believe that they are stemming their power from the mighty Allah Azza wa Jal. And on the other side, we are seeing the most sophisticated weapons on earth. The missile guided and the smartest and all the baloney. All these things are being targeting hospitals. We never heard in the history of mankind any army that have targeted hospitals for Allah's sake. We never heard in the history of mankind that an army will be targeting schools of the United Nations in which people have sought refuge. Where are the people of Gaza are going to run and go and seek refuge? The Gaza Strip is a very small geographical area. We have 1.7 almost million people living in a very small geographical area. The highly dense population on earth. Where are the people are going to flee? The borders between them and Israel is blocked. And unfortunately, the borders between them and the hypocrites of the Muslim Ummah is always blocked. Why on earth the government of Egypt is blocking the borders between them and the Palestinians in Gaza? I cannot find an answer or justification to this ever. And this is a big shame on the forehead of the government of Egypt until the day of judgment. We're not talking about the people of Egypt. The people of Egypt are boiling. The people in the streets are shouting. There have been demonstrations. There are people have been killed in their demonstrations, trying to make their voice heard. Why on earth our government is blocking the aid from those civilians who wants the physical, the food, they want the medical aid to be able to save lives? Listen to the internet. Go on the internet. And Google and listen to the Norwegian medical doctor who have been prevented by the Egyptian government from entering to Rafah to go and aid the Palestinian civilians who are being killed and tortured. He had to manipulate and go around until he made it inside Gaza. Listen to his testimony. Listen to what he's saying. Listen to the hypocrisy of the international community. Pokemon, this man who's supposed to represent peace on earth is going to Israel and cry on the soldiers
who have been carrying weapons and assaulting Palestinians, crying over their coffins, and did not even bother to know what's happening in Gaza? Are the people, the children of Gaza, less human than the soldiers of Israel? That's a big shame on the international community. That's a big shame on the whole world who's keeping a mouth shut on what's happening in Gaza. And I do not speak on behalf of the Palestinians. I wish that Allah will help me to be able to serve them. And I wish that I can clean and polish their own shoes, because they have set the standards of ethics. They have been in so much pain, and they have seen their own people, civilians, being killed. But they said, we are people of ethics. We are people stemming our power from the mighty Allah Azza wa Jal only. And therefore, we are not going to do anything that would make Allah Azza wa Jal unhappy with us. There are zero civilians killed in this war, and there's countless civilians from the Palestinian sides. And we're saying this, we're not saying this proudly. We know war is very painful, and every killed person is a loss to their family members, including the soldiers. There's a big number of soldiers who are coming to attack the Palestinians falling. Shame on the state of Israel. Shame on the government of Israel, who are sending their own young men to be killed as a result of their own stubbornness. Hamas did not initiate the Palestinian, did not initiate this war. It's the siege on Gaza since 2005 have started this war. And the continuous assault in 2008 and 2010 and 2012 and 2013. Gaza is not an experimental field for the most sophisticated weapons of the Americans and the US government. We have nothing against the U.S. people. They are lovely people. Shame on the government of the U.S., which have misrepresented their own people. And shame on those who are blindly following their footsteps, including our own government. We have been proud as Canadians because we have been a peacekeeper and broker. We say to our government today, do not blindly close your eyes and follow the footsteps of those who are zalim. But rather go back to your own conscience and represent us as Canadians. If you want to speak about your own self. Do not speak about us as Canadians. This is what's happening right now in Gaza. There's siege since 2005. And there has been continuing assaults upon assaults and casualties upon casualties. Palestinians deserve to live with integrity. Palestinians deserve to be able to leave the big siege and prison that is called Gaza, so that they're able to make it outside for treatment. The number of those who have been killed during the assault is 800-something. But the number of those who has been killed throughout the years and yearly is triple that as a result of the siege, as a result of the lack of the food supplies, as a result of the lack of the medical supplies, as a result of the Palestinians living in a big prison that is called Gaza. There are women who have given birth on the checkpoints. There are elders who have died and children who have died trying to make it to cross the border to seek treatment for their own children. For Allah's sake, where is the Muslim intro? Where is the international community? This is hypocrisy. This is a big hypocrisy. And today, the Palestinians who have no army and who are trying to whatever means they have in their hand by making rockets underground by hand are sending a strong message to the puppets of the Muslim Ummah and telling them, in your what so-called 6 days war, when all the Arab countries have allied supposedly to stand against the Israelis and Umm Kulthum and the Arab singers were packing them up, they were all defeated within 6 days. So far, 18 days, and the Palestinians have demonstrated to the whole world that your weapons, your F-16, your most sophisticated weapons are not going to defeat our spirit, because we are not being backed by the U.S. We are being backed by Allah the Mighty. We are being backed by Allah the Mighty. And who is going to defeat Allah? No one. Wake up, the Muslim leaders. Wake up. I feel like I want to collect money of donation and buy for every single Muslim leader and Arab leader a hijab. Because you should not be standing in front of the cameras without a hijab. Because this is awra. You are a person who should be wearing a hijab. Step aside, let someone else to be stand up to be able to defend the integrity of the Muslim Ummah. These are facts that we need to be aware of. The Muslim of Gaza are being killed. They have been killed slowly and now being killed fast. May Allah Azza wa Jal give them the victory. May Allah send down on them the rahmah. May Allah Azza wa Jal give them the nasr. Allahumma ameen. Wa aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li lakum fastaghfiruh. Alhamdulillah, نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا وسيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا يا ايها الذين امنوا اذكروا نعمة الله عليكم اذ جاءتكم جنود فارسلنا عليها جنود وريحا لم تروها وانزل الله فارسلنا عليها جنود وريحا وجنود لم تروها الله عز وجل have revealed to us in the Quran a chapter by the title of Al-Ahzab, the Confederators. And we do have in the history of Islam a battle that is called Al-Ahzab or Al-Khandaq, the trench. And interestingly enough, Al-Khandaq in the Arabic language could mean a trench and could mean a tunnel. And we are right now seeing in Gaza history repeating itself. We are seeing the battle of the trench. We are seeing the battle of the Al-Khandaq, Al-Anfaq. And Allah Azza wa Jal have demonstrated to us and have shown us that those who would have, who would rely on Allah Azza wa Jal, as it has been the case with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihim and the Sahaba, إِذْ جَاءُوكُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ وَمِنْ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ وَإِذْ زَاغَتِ الْأَبْصَارُ وَبَلَغَتِ الْقُلُوبُ الْحَنَاجِرُ وَتَظُنُّونَ بِاللَّهِ الظُّنُونَ When they have come to you from the air, and when they have come to you from the sea, and when they come to you from the land, and your hearts have reached the throat, and your eyes were wondering, and you start having doubts about what is happening. And that's exactly what's happening to our brothers and sisters in Gaza. War is no fun. Killing children is no fun. Wallahi, the cry and the shout and the wailing of the mother who have lost all her family members is so painful that cannot make us be able to sleep comfortable at night. Wallahi, the children of Palestine are so valuable just like any other children. They do not give birth to children so that they get killed by the Israeli weapons. For Allah's sake, just today before coming, a child of 5 years old was shot in the head. For Allah's sake, why an Israeli sniper would be shooting a 5 years old child in the head? Is that a child that has driving a tank? Is this a child who's riding an airplane? Is this a child that have a rifle to assault someone? For Allah's sake, where are the ethics? Yeah, where are the ethics of the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal? من قتل نفسا فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا What happened to Fir'aun? What happened to those who are stood against the believers in the history of mankind? We call upon Israelis to wake up to their conscience and to the scripts of the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah Azza wa Jal is telling us, وَإِذْ جَاءُوكُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ مِنْ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ وَإِذْ زَاغَتِ الْقُلُوبُ وَبَلَغَتِ الْأَبْصَارُ وَبَلَغَتِ الْقُلُوبُ الْحَنَاجِرُ وَتَظُنُّونَ بِاللَّهِ ظُنُونَا لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر ولما رأى المؤمنون الأحزاب قالوا هذا ما وعدنا الله ورسوله وصدق الله ورسوله وما زادهم إلا إيمانا وتسليما Allahu Akbar. That's exactly what we are hearing now from the Palestinians. When they saw the Confederators, when they saw the Israelis backed by all the Western powers, they said, هَذَا مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. This is exactly what Allah and His Prophet had promised us. وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. And they did not increase except Iman and believing in Allah Azza wa Jal. You hear the children in the streets, you hear the elders in the hospitals, you hear all the people walking in the streets of Gaza saying, Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. They're saying, Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakil. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakil. On those hypocrites who are sending themselves to the dumpsters of the history, we say to everyone, stand up firm and speak the truth. Speak the truth so that you are able to stand for the rights, for human rights. Forget about the ethical, forget about religious rights. We're talking about human rights and ethics. Let's stand up all together and say enough is enough. Let's send emails to our member of parliaments and say to them, what is happening in Gaza? What is our government is doing? Where is our stand from the killing of civilians? The Palestinians did not start the war. It's Israel's aggression and continuous aggression and siege on Gaza that have started the war. And the Palestinians are demanding to live in integrity. We no longer want to live under siege. We want to be able to have a normal life. We're no longer being looked at like this. We will be speaking equally to anyone. We will not be bowing to anyone. And we are stemming our power from the mighty Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah Azza wa Jal will be giving us the victory. And at the end of the battle of Al-Ahzab, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said a word, Al-an naghzuhum wa la yaghzuna. Today, we will go after them and they will not be coming after us. And inshallah, the Palestinians are saying, Al-an naghzuhum wa la yaghzuna. إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك اللهم على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم إنا عبيدك أبناء عبيدك أبناء إمائك نواصينا بيدك ماض فينا حكمك عدل فينا قضاءك نسألك اللهم بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك بأن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا يا الله اللهم اجعله جلاء لهمومنا وأحزاننا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم نسألك في هذا الشهر المبارك ونسألك في هذه الأيام الفضيلة ونسألك في هذه الساعة وهي ساعة إجابة بأن تفرج قربنا يا رب العالمين اللهم أقر عيننا بنص دينك يا رب العالمين اللهم أنزل الرحمات اللهم أنزل الملائكة من عندك على أهلنا في غزة يا رب العالمين اللهم انصرهم يا رب العالمين اللهم ثبت أقدامهم اللهم عليك بقتلة أنبيائك يا رب العالمين اللهم عليك بمن قالوا إن يد الله مغلولة غلت أيديهم ولعنوا بما قالوا بل يداه مبسوطتان ينفق كيف يشاء اللهم عليك بمن باء عليهم غضبك يا رب العالمين اللهم زلزل الأرض من تحت أقدامهم فإنهم لا يعجزونك يا اللهم نسألك بأنك أنت الله الذي لا إله غيرك بأن لا تحرمنا أجر الصيام ولا تحرمنا أجر القيام وقراءة القرآن والإنفاق في سبيلك يا رب العالمين اللهم هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما اللهم اغفر لوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربيانا صغيرا Oh Allah we pray to you we supplicate to you to restore justice and peace on earth يا رب العالمين يا الله we pray to you we supplicate to you to restore justice and peace on earth يا رب العالمين يا الله we pray to you to save the bloods of those who are being killed يا الله we ask you to have rahma on those children and the elders and the women of Palestine and everywhere يا رب العالمين يا الله we ask you to stop and finish every tyrant يا رب العالمين يا الله we pray to you we supplicate to you to accept from us our siyam and our qiyam and our qiraat of the Quran and make us from those who will be getting Laylat al-Qadr اللهم آمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وأقم الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استوى تدلو أثابني أثابكم الله Let's make sure our lines are straight We have more room inside, inshallah. If there are brothers standing in the back, we have more room inside the masjid, inshallah. Let's fill the first lines first, and then we go. I don't think we need another one. Do we need another line here?
I don't know.
We have, alhamdulillah. We're good. Okay. Alhamdulillah. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. إذ تصعدون ولا تلوون على أحد، والرسول يدعوكم في أخراكم فأثابكم غما بغم لكي لا تحزنوا على ما فاتكم ولا ما أصابكم، والله خبير بما تعملون. ثم أنزل عليكم من بعد الغم أمنة نعاسا يغشى طائفة منكم، وطائفة قد أهمتهم أنفسهم يقولون هل لنا من الأمر من شيء، قل إن الأمر كله لله، يخفون في أنفسهم ما لا يبدون لك، يقولون لو كان لنا من الأمر من شيء ما قتلنا هاهنا، قل لو كنتم في بيوتكم لبرز الذين كتب عليهم القتل إلى مضاجعهم، وليبتلي الله ما في صدوركم وليمحص ما في قلوبكم، إن الله بما تعملون بصير. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اصبروا وصابروا ورابطوا واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين. إن شاء الله quickly we have tonight. إن شاء الله we have a special program. I would like to, on behalf of the masjid, to invite everyone and your family members to come for iftar. We have a special iftar tonight, inshallah. So please make sure that you come with your family members, your neighbors, your friend, even non-Muslims, if they are interested to come, let them come, inshallah, so that we're able to enjoy together, you know, the last Jum'ah of Ramadan. Because tonight we have Khidmat al-Quran. And tonight we're having, you know, a special, inshallah, Taraweeh, because it's going to be, should I say the surprise or leave it for tonight? Inshallah, we'll be, inshallah, in the new hall. Inshallah, the new hall is ready for us to use. So we would like to invite everyone for iftar tonight and a special taraweeh with khidmat al-Quran and a dua, inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan. Let's, inshallah, not say that the 27 is gone. No, we still have the last minute of the month of Ramadan. And akhir layla min Ramadan is the layla, the last night of the month of Ramadan is the night of payment. Because the one, you know, get paid after they finish their job. So this is, inshallah, will continue with the same pattern of ibadat all the way until the end of the month of Ramadan, inshallah. May Allah accept from us, Allahumma ameen, jazakumullah khairan, and we'll see you all, inshallah, tonight.
If someone cannot come for iftar, time, 10 o'clock.
If you're unable to make it for iftar, which we hope you not, you'll, inshallah, be coming to the iftar, then the program starts for taraweeh, inshallah, at 10 o'clock. Inshallah. 10 o'clock, inshallah, that's good, yeah. Inshallah, 10 o'clock, our program will start. Just make sure, inshallah, you come with your children and your family members. Jazakumullah khairan.
Thank you.
Thank
you,
inshallah.
بارك الله فيك ان شاء الله.